Today, I'm going to show you how I manage my YouTube channel assets using Airtable. I decided to use Airtable because I can embed particular views that I want to show people, and I can also upload and manage the assets really easy in it. So I'm just going to take you through my setup here. The first table that I have in my YouTube base is for my content. So each week when I do my videos, this is where I start planning out everything that I need to go into YouTube itself. So I'll have already done some keyword research and pulled in the keyword that I'm going to focus on for the week. So last week's video was related to MeisterTask and doing a review. So that is the keyword that I wanted to focus on. Over here, I've got the title of the video. I've also got the video tags that I'm going to use here. And I have some notes to myself because I learned how to do this channel from watching Sunny Leonarduzzi's videos. And if you're interested in doing a YouTube channel, I strongly advise you to follow her stuff. The next field here that I have is the description of the video, including the title, making sure that I have everything in here that I need. If I actually do a resource mention, as I call it, I just check off this field here just to remind myself that I did put links in there. I also put the name of the MP4 file. I have a stage here. So as I'm working on the video and getting it ready, I have, you know, draft and in progress. And then once everything is actually loaded up into YouTube, the video's published, and I've actually pushed everything into this Airtable base, then I change it to posted, and I'll show you why in just a second. I have the post date, I upload my custom thumbnail that I do, I put the YouTube link, and then I also upload the SRT and transcript files. And the reason I'm doing that is right now I am not transcribing my videos over into blog posts, but I know I want to do that in the future and include some written tutorials. So by having the transcripts uploaded, I've already got the text to get me started really quickly on what I'd like to say in a written post. So the reason I said I included that I changed this field to posted is because I've got a particular view here and it's only filtering in videos that are posted. So I've got these cool cards. I've just shown as the cover photo, my thumbnail, the title, what the link is, and when it was posted. So what I do is as I'm building out some more features on my website, let me jump over to my site. As we come over here, what I'm adding in is this table here. So this is just an embed from Airtable that has all of my videos. So that way it saves me some time because I don't have to come over here to my site and do a whole nother process just to get the videos on. I just make use of the Airtable base to cover this and actually managing the assets. So back over here, one last thing I'd like to show is my channel. I didn't start tracking the views and total subscribers right away, but when I thought about it, that was obviously on May 3rd. So that's when I started tracking, because what can happen is as you're starting your channel, and mine is still pretty new, it can feel like, you know, am I going to get any traction with this? And I know that I will, but I think numbers and visuals help you to see that, yes, you really are growing. So whenever I kind of think about it, I just come in here and put the date. And I came in here and looked at today's date right before I did this and put in what the numbers are. And then for this base, I'm actually using a pro plan for Airtable, so that I can use the blocks feature. And this isn't necessary. I mean, you could just look at your data, but I like to see kind of a chart to see, hey, look, you know, I'm growing in subscribers. This is the number of views I have. So over time, I could start to see trends and really see visually that I'm growing. So I hope that helps. Some use cases for this other than just putting the YouTube content on your website. A couple of use cases I thought of as well is I'm in a couple of groups where the group leaders are posting lots of videos via Zoom. They're doing Facebook Lives. They're doing YouTube videos. A really easy way to manage all of those videos and share all of them in one place would be to use something like this. I know lots of times in Facebook groups, it's hard to find things. The search feature is not the greatest, but if you started to manage your assets in something like this Airtable base, you'd have an easy way to keep everything in one place, and you can actually share a link just to this particular view within a Facebook group, and then anybody who's in there could immediately see all of your videos right away. So I hope that was helpful, and I will see you next week. So hopefully you will let me know in the comments if this was helpful to you, and if you have any questions about whether YouTube or any other assets can be managed in Airtable, I'll be happy to answer them.